All right, what's going on, guys? This is Logan with West Desert Wheeler. Super excited for this one. We have a really cool opportunity. During Trail Hero Week, a bunch of badass drivers show up, and today I am out here on the trail with these guys. Not only that, I was able to find myself a rental buggy to drive around with these guys. It's gonna be hard to keep up, but we've got Jeff McKinley in the lead. We just ran up the beginning of the Ironman Trail. It is named because of Jeff McKinley. And then we're going to be chasing Jesse Haynes, who was kind enough to let me borrow his two-seat car. He is out here in a single-seat moon buggy. I think he's standing over here somewhere. But so thank you very much, Jesse. I greatly appreciate that. We got Caleb Redden with us. We got Dave Wong. We got a few other guys out here. It's gonna be a great time on the rocks. Let's take a quick peek at Jeff's car. This thing is fresh, looks awesome, made of all the best and newest stuff. Super excited to see this thing get out here. Really nice build Jeff did here. Well, let's go take a peek at some of these other cars. We got Caleb Redden's car. This thing gets rowdy. Caleb's always out here smiling, having a good time on the trails. Super badass. And then this is Jesse's competition car. He refers to this one as Tigger. Single seat, moon buggy, four link, all the good stuff. 50 degrees of steering. Powerful supercharged four cylinder in this one. This thing is super rad. And right here we got a red dot pulling up into the Ironman Trail. All the good stuff out on the trail here today. Let's take a look at the car I am fortunate enough to jump into and drive. This is the two-seat Jesse Haynes Trail chassis. Of course, he's put all of his cast portal boxes on there. That's new from Jesse Haynes. Lots of really cool parts. And this thing has a turbo four cylinder in this one. Just super clean, no bullshit build. Love it. It's wheeling great too. All right, guys, so we've got Caleb, Jesse, and Jeff here. None of them are particularly excited to go into this obstacle. This was a trail breaker, the first one. And they're all talking, it's pretty nasty in here, so I'm excited to see these cars get put to work. You can see there's just so little room for anything to go. A steep climb. And I've mentioned this in videos before, spotting a driver is one thing, seeing what the car needs from the outside, but you have to be a very talented driver to do all that from the driver's seat, especially on obstacles like this, where it's just this wildly difficult. I can see from this angle, Jeff has good visibility. Rear wheel drive only. Back to four wheel. To get that cage out of that overhang. His hood is just right up into it. Front winch. His roof is just about into these rocks. He's trying to pull that front end down. Slam. Curious how this left rear is gonna go. It honestly doesn't look too bad. Using his max drive in this car. kind of leveled out. What we came out here to see today, guys. See the most capable cars push hard. His rears in there real hard, starting to work that rear end up level. I think he's about to get it. There it goes. Still gotta watch that roof. To make this car as flat as possible. On top of that, this is one of the like most pancaked cars there is. The roof line is real low on this. Just about there. She wants it. And there it is. Iron Man himself getting through again. On a really ugly obstacle. Jesse working his way into this one. Rear also dropped down. Going for a rear only, gonna turn back into that wall. Back to four wheel. Plenty of clearance on that roof. Into this one. Got them chrome 20-inch wheels. I These guys love to play their own game and figure it out. Funny, it doesn't look like that's what you should do, but it works. And it all twisted up. Guys, we got Dave Wong out here in his Jesse Haynes moon buggy. Dave is a Trailbreaker winner in 2022. Now he's excited to get back into Trailbreaker this year, which is on Thursday. We're currently filming this on Wednesday, so boys are getting ready. Dave has one of the most meticulously maintained moon buggies I've seen. Takes real good care of this car. Got a big climb. There she goes. Just gonna grease his way through that one. Very nice work, Dave. Yeah, that was good stuff. Little pinch after that big overhang, and this can't be discounted either. This has proven to be difficult here. Curious if the narrow car makes it more tricky. Stretching out the four link. Got it leveled out, looking really good. problem solving. Good driving, Dave. now, guys. This is the wildest shit I've seen. McKinley dropping in, off camber, big hole. I'm sure that doesn't feel good in the driver's seat. All right, guys, so we're on Ironman, one of the most notoriously challenging trails in Sand Hollow. We run the hardest line that most locals don't usually run. And here we have Caleb Redden and Jesse running bonus lines on this. Caleb doing this reverse drop-in down into Ironman. got his helmet on now, so he's ready to party. He's in full party mode. This wall is 8 to 10 feet tall. I'm holding the camera at 6 feet eye level. And when you're harnessed in these cars, it's really hard to look over your shoulders. So he's limiting his visibility because he's got his harnesses on. And he's doing a crazy ass drop. So just keep all that in mind. He's gonna put it in front wheel drive only to see if it'll settle the front.
Yeah.
few people who get into a position like that and are excited. Jesse Haynes there. Caleb earned that one. Way to go, dude. That was badass. Party on, Garth.
Anything else in Santa Hollow is like one of those where if you're on the right line, it just goes right up, and if you're on the wrong line, it
just... Kinley getting squared up to go up this one. It's steep. A lot of sand in there. Big drop off the passenger side of the car. As a driver, it doesn't ever feel good to be that close to the ledge. forward way by his car. Even on an incline, it did. All right, boys, we jumped over to King Crack on Arrowhead. Got a bunch of buggies over here. Got Jeff rolling up. Should be a good time. We're gonna hit the optional lines out here at Arrowhead. So King Crack is just to the right. This one has really vertical walls and pinches your sidewalls really hard. Can be a little tricky. And it's got a pretty good climb at the top. His car is very narrow, so he's going to be down further in the crack. Curious what he's going to do with his rear. Gonna shoot the wall or not, just cruise up it. Just in, and then McKinley is trying to get to the top apparently. Going to the top of the mountain. Right on, guys, we made it out to the end of Arrowhead. Thank you guys very much for showing off, beating on your cars. You guys are a bunch of badasses. It was a great time on the rocks. We'll see you guys next time.
Thank you.